Hi, it's Barb and Gabby again. We are in what I would consider probably the squatchiest place I've been to yet. We just found this the other night. We are about half a mile from the cabin upriver on the other side. And this is an old road that's overgrown, and I believe this is called gating. This is where it starts here. Some pretty interesting stuff through here. So we're just going to take a little walk down the road here and show you some of the stuff that's here and talk about why I'm here. I've been wanting to get to this spot for quite some time. I know the elk have been hanging out in here a lot lately, and this is very near where a neighbor lady told me that she hears a lot of screams and rocks clacking coming from this area. And look at all this stuff. The other night we went all the way down through here, and we went off this road a ways on either side. And once you get away from here, you don't really see any of this down broken stuff anymore. Most of it looks like it's pretty old. I haven't really been out here at all in years, so this is all pretty new to me. But it's very interesting, all this stuff down across the road here. But one of the reasons I wanted to get out here was a few months ago at the store, there's this guy that comes in, and he always gets a payday bar. And one week he bought his payday bar and he left, and he came back because it had open wrapper and it was stale, so he exchanged it. And the next week he came in and I told him that I had taken that payday bar out in the woods and left it for Bigfoot. Well, his eyes got really big, and he told me that a few weeks before that he had been coming down the highway and he saw all the elk run across, so he pulled over to watch them and found a little side road just off to the east of town. And he said he got out and he was watching the elk, and he looked over, and about a quarter mile away there was a large upright gorilla watching him. And he looked at it for a few minutes, and it looked at him, and then it turned and walked off after the elk. So that was where we are now, is probably about halfway between that spot and the cabin. Look at these here, all snapped off, and you can see there's nothing that came down and broke them. All snapped off there. So I've really been wanting to get out into this area, just haven't managed to do it till lately. And when we were here the other night, we heard some really strange whistles. Kim's got those on tape, so I think we'll be putting together a video with some of the sounds we've been hearing out here. It'll be probably on an upcoming episode of the Barb and Gabby Show. I like that, Barb and Gabby Show. Cracks me up. So, this is rock underneath here. It's an old road and it hasn't been used in a really long time. It doesn't even look like anybody uses it to walk. Yeah, the whistles we heard the other night, there was one came from back that way, and it was like a really long, intense thrush whistle. And there was just one. There was no other thrushes whistling. And then from the opposite side of the road, just a few seconds later, we heard two more whistles that responded to it, and that was it. So I think they might have been out here, and they knew we were here. Just sending each other signals. Here's two more of these trees that are just snapped off right there. You can see nothing fell on them. Nothing broke them. And this moss in here is really torn up too. A lot of this along here. think I'd like to spend a lot more time out here. I'm really kind of kicking myself for not having gotten out this way sooner. It's all torn up, just all over the place. And I don't really see any elk tracks through here. And there are animal trails, but I don't know what all this torn up moss is about. And off to that side, out there, there is a kind of a big swampy area between here and the river. This little area that we're in here is probably a couple of hundred acres that's pretty flat. It's between the two rivers. That's pretty interesting. And the last time I was out here, it was all still just tiny trees. Wasn't grown up like this. Pushed over. Yeah, we came out here the other night and my friend Kim was with me and it was getting dark and she was pretty nervous. This tree out here bent. That one's dead. It's been that way a while, but it's bent over the top of this one and this one is not dead. That one's alive. You can see how folded over under this other one. So yeah, this is probably about as squatchy a place as you could ask for out here. And I've seen a lot of this stuff along the creek and the trail and along the river, but I've never found such a concentrated area of so many things bent down and broken. Another one broken there. Doesn't look real new, but oh. And you get out into the woods on either side and it's really not like this out there. Everything is still pretty young and healthy and standing. It's beautiful in here though, isn't it? Absolutely gorgeous. Like we're even going to get a little bit of sun today. Not that. There's an X. Right there. That one's broken off. Stripped. Right there. Looks like some elk rubs over there. There's some more of this worn up moss. I've been finding this along the trail too, and I was thinking maybe it had something to do with hunting, you know, like catching squirrels or the mountain beavers, you know, if they got them with the front feet, you know, dragging them around, or hands dragging them around. A little animal trail here. So I think I'm going to try and spend some more time out here, especially later in the evening. What's that for a break? I see nothing fell on it. Just snapped and splintered right there. Like I said, I don't know how long any of this has been like this. None of these breaks look particularly new, but this area is new to me. Oh, I figure I kind of need to take stock of what's what out here, so the next time I pass through, I will know when something's new. I think this was probably logged out here 20 years or so ago, long time ago. I've had plenty of time to grow back up. I believe this used to be a campground out in here way back when, long before my time. Only got a few more minutes here before the video is going to be too long for YouTube. Like, we kind of run out of the road here. We're just on the animal trails now. It's alive when it's leaning a little bit. Okay, well, I guess that's about the end of that little road. But we are going to keep looking out here. We're going to keep listening. We're going to try and spend a little more time out in this area. And if we find anything, hear anything, we'll let you know. So, thanks for watching. Bye.